Hello and welcome to this Brooklyn Public Library tutorial on copyright. Let's go over some common questions that come up at the library. Copyright is essentially a limited monopoly granted to the creator of a work, although in recent decades this monopoly has become significantly longer. Article 1, Section 8 of the U.S. Constitution states that among the powers of Congress is to promote the progress of science and useful arts by securing for limited times to authors and inventors the exclusive right to their respective writings and discoveries. So the original idea of copyright here is to protect the rights of the creators while also stimulating creation for the benefit of everyone. Under the provisions of the Copyright Act of 1976 and those of the Copyright Term Extension Act of 1998, a work that was created on or after January 1, 1978 is automatically protected from the moment of its creation and lasts for the duration of the creator's life plus an additional 70 years after his or her death. Since that 1976 Copyright Act took effect, copyright is automatic once the work is in a fixed and tangible form. So once you commit something to paper or another device, it is under copyright. That includes even works that have not been published or publicly distributed, such as diaries, drawings, blog posts, and drafts of song lyrics. A dance is an example of a creation that is not under copyright unless it has been recorded or documented in some way. Registration of your copyright is voluntary. However, one advantage is the fact that registration is necessary if you'll have to file a copyright infringement suit in court. Don't just Google for websites with information about copyright and registration. The only agency in this country that issues an actual copyright is the U.S. Copyright Office. Don't pay anyone else to register your work. Getting an ISBN for your book has to do with publishing, by the way, which is a whole separate topic from copyright. And if you've got an invention that you want to register, copyright is not what you're looking for. A patent is what protects an invention. Copyleft refers to a public license that allows for people to make their creations available to others to use, adapt, and distribute before that life of the creator plus 70 years period has passed. Some Creative Commons licenses follow the copyleft philosophy. People who license their content under Creative Commons can specify that other people can reproduce their work if they give attribution to the creator, if they use the work only in a non-commercial manner, and/or if they share any adaptations of the original work in the same copyleft manner. Sometimes copyrighted material can be used without permission under fair use. Among the criteria are the purpose and character of the use, such as whether it's commercial or educational, and the amount of the original work used. There is no magic formula for calculating whether a particular use of copyrighted material is acceptable under fair use guidelines. A common part of a homework assignment is when kids have to find images to print or photocopy. Reproduction of a copyrighted image in a school report that will be seen only by the teacher is likely to fall under fair use. Nevertheless, it's always a good idea for everyone to understand that reproducing images and text from web pages may violate the legal rights of the people who created those works. At the very least, kids should know that it's important to cite the sources of the pictures they print, just as they would cite books in their bibliographies. But do remember that citing a source is not a substitute for obtaining permission to use it. Let's talk about the public domain. In the words of Project Gutenberg, the public domain is the set of cultural works that are free of copyright and belong to everyone equally. Books are considered to be in the public domain in the U.S. if they were published before 1923, if they're U.S. government publications, or if they fall into a few other situations. Just because a book is out of print does not necessarily mean it's out of copyright, and there could be many reasons a copyright holder has not digitized the text. And even for works in the public domain, they don't automatically appear online. Organizations such as Project Gutenberg and the Internet Archive work hard to create digital files for books in the public domain, but of course they haven't gotten to everything yet. Most books that were published since 1923 have gone out of print but are still under copyright. Some of these are so-called orphan works, meaning the copyright owners cannot be found. If you're unsure about the status of a work, you can consult resources on the U.S. Copyright Office website. So this was a short taste of copyright questions that come up at the library. Speaking of copyright, all of the photographs used in this video were posted online under a Creative Commons license, and this video itself is licensed under Creative Commons. Feel free to share. Thanks for watching this Brooklyn Public Library tutorial. If you have questions, we're available at your local library as well as via online chat, email, or telephone.